My brothers and sisters in Christ, today the Church celebrates the memorial of St. Nicholas of Myra, the 4th century bishop and saint who lies behind the origin of so many of the Santa Claus traditions. You know, there's a tension in Christian circles nowadays between those who fully embrace and see, you know, in the image of Santa Claus so prominent during Christmas season as something good and wholesome for children, as opposed to those who see it as something that detracts completely from the real meaning of Christmas and the gift that is Jesus. But in fact, celebrations such as today reminds us that the truth can lie somewhere in the middle. It's one of where is our focus? So the image of Santa Claus, now of course there's many legends associated with St. Nicholas, and so we always have to parse, and of course even the basic ones aren't one that are historically provable, and yet his sanctity was proclaimed by the people of God. So we know they're rooted in some principle of generosity that were at the heart of all of these. So as the young bishop that was noted for his generosity, he was a bishop who had a mighty inheritance, he had means of his own, but he in turn used all of that to help the poor, as opposed to living lavishly himself. And so the most famous legend with St. Nicholas was that there was a man, a poor man who had 3 daughters of marriageable age, but he didn't have the dowry needed to arrange marriages for each of his daughters, and concerned that they might end up in prostitution or something else because they couldn't get married without a dowry. And on each occasion, a bag of gold was found lying inside the house. It said that St. Nicholas would walk by and throw a bag of gold through the window to provide the dowry. And the further the legend says that these bags of gold always landed in the shoes that had been set out by the fire to dry out. And so this was the origin of the idea of stockings being hung and the gifts being found in the stockings. Of course, the very name of St. Nicholas, eventually in English-speaking countries, got misunderstood as names and words change over centuries to Santa Claus. And even the candy canes we eat, the origin of the crooked candy cane was from the crozier of St. Nicholas. And so we can trace many of the secularized images to this holy story, but at the heart of the legend is the generosity of St. Nicholas. That is what captured the heart of people and led them to Christ. He was a bishop, a man of great generosity and faithfulness to God. He helped people constantly, and in this, he pointed them to the Lord. And so as we look at our traditions that we celebrate around Christmas time, today's celebration, first of all, it's wonderful to teach children about St. Nicholas himself. You know, put small gifts or something in their shoes, you know, the tradition of leaving shoes out the door, this kind of thing. But also, regardless of how the traditions get celebrated in the household, whether Santa Claus is invited or not, yes, the focus should be Christ, but also what points to Christ is the generosity. And so the gift giving is important, not for the sake of the gifts, and that's where we get in trouble, the commercialism, it's all about the presents, you know, what to get, but the idea of the generosity of giving to one another. This comes from the legend of St. Nicholas, and what does this generosity point to? It points to the gift of Christ, the greatest gift of all, but also the generous love of God by which Christ comes to us, the Son of God made flesh. And so, my brothers and sisters, and our families and our households, may we celebrate these holidays well. And of course, celebrate Advent first. Christmas can wait. We get a whole season of it starting on Christmas Day. We need to celebrate Advent now. But may days like today with St. Nicholas, may we recapture the roots of these beautiful traditions and legends so that in all of them, all of the saints in their glory ultimately point us to the goodness of Christ. May we make sure everything that we're saying and doing is in some way either preparing ourselves to receive Christ or helping to draw to others, draw our families mindfulness to the generosity, the gift of God, and his commandment that we share, that we be generous to one another. Saint Nicholas, pray for us.